In this video, I'm gonna show you how to transform the answers from this Google form into this beautiful certificates for all of your recipients. Hi there, my name is Uliana, and if you clicked on this video, then most probably you're using Google Forms to run some test, quiz, or survey. And now you've come up with this brilliant idea to start rewarding your Google Forms respondents with a shiny certificate delivered straight to their inboxes. The first thing that you'll have to do is to transform all of your responses into a spreadsheet. Just go open your Google Forms, open the form that you have sent to all of your students. Let's go to the responses tab and create a spreadsheet based on the answers that we have collected. Now let's hit this button, create, and we are generating a spreadsheet with all our answers. Basically, a rule of thumb is that you don't have to do anything with your spreadsheet. Even if it's long, if it has a lot of columns, just feel free to leave it the way it is. You don't have to delete any unnecessary stuff. Just ensure that your spreadsheet contains all of your recipient names and all of your recipient emails, because we will use them to generate and email your certificates. Now what you want to do is to go to certifier.io and create your free Certifier account. The process of registration is very easy and straightforward. It should take you no longer than 2 minutes. So I'm a registered user. I'll just go and log into my Certifier account. Upon logging in, you have to create your certificate design. Let's go to the Designs tab, click on this button, Create Design, and choose the certificate design option. The good news is that you don't have to create your certificate design from scratch. You can choose from a variety of professionally designed certificate templates and basically tailor them according to your needs. So let's use this certificate template. As you can see, it has a lot of elements. It has some like visual elements. It has a lot of text. So just feel free to interact with this template to like customize, to remove any unwanted stuff, to upload your logo, signature, some images, edit the text, etc. I won't be spending a lot of time doing this. I'll just show you some basic customization. For example, let's delete this logo placeholder that we have. Let's go to the Elements tab and upload the logo straight from our computer. I have prepared this logo. Let's make it smaller and place it here. Let's remove this text. Here we have some description of this certificate, so let's change it to this description. You can also change the size of the text. You can also change the font, colors, I mean, basically anything that you can think about. And you might have noticed that I'm not doing anything to these words written in the brackets. So for example, the certificate design has the certificate UUID text written in the brackets, some certificate issued on text written in the brackets, and this recipient name text. So technically, this is not a text. These are dynamic attributes. The possibility to place dynamic attributes is what makes Certifier truly powerful and different from other certificate makers that you might have used before. With the help of dynamic attributes, you can create a single certificate design that can be later on used to generate dozens, hundreds, or even thousands of digital certificates. So just trust the process, let's leave the fields untouched, and you will see the magic happening in a couple of minutes. So now once you are satisfied with your certificate design, let's click on this button, Create Certificate Design. And we have to tell Certifier a little bit more about the event that we have conducted. So everything that you have to do is to go to the group section and create a group. Here in this section, you should provide the name of the event that you conducted. So in our case, that's Planets and the Solar System Basic Quiz. Let's add this name here. You can also add the description, like describe in detail what your recipients had to do in order to get this award, add the link to your online course if this quiz was a part of some online course, add some skills that your recipients obtained, or specify whether you would like the certificate to expire in the future. Now let's select the appearance, like the design that we have prepared for this group. Here is how it looks like. And here in the delivery section, you have to select the template that you would like to use to distribute your certificate straight to your recipients. Well, this is how the default email template looks like, but actually you can also fully customize it. And here is how a customized email template looks like. As you can see, it also has the logo of the company that conducted this quiz. It has also some description. It has our company's colors. I mean, everything looks branded and aligned. Upon creating a group, we have to go back to our recipient list and export it in Microsoft Excel or CSV format. So for the purposes of this video, I will use this long list just to show you that you shouldn't be afraid even if your spreadsheet is very long, it has a lot of columns. Let's export this video in this Microsoft Excel format. Let's save it straight to our computers. And now let's go back to Certifier. Click on this button, Issue Credentials. Select this spreadsheet upload option and proceed with uploading the list of our recipients. This is the list that we have just saved. So as you can see, Certifier asks us what are the columns that we would like to use to generate the certificate. So in our case, we will take only the data that is stored in the name and email columns. So we won't be using all of this other columns. So let's proceed with this two options and click on this button, next. So now it is high time to map the columns with the values from our spreadsheet to the dynamic attributes that we used in our certificate designs, in the email templates, or in our email body text. So in our case, we have a column that's called name. It has all of our recipient names and it corresponds to this recipient name attribute. The other column is called email. It has all of our recipients' emails and the values from this column correspond to our recipient email attribute. Your goal here is to achieve a state where you will have this green alert that says that you have zero invalid records. Now let's hit this preview before publishing button. One more beauty of Certifier is the fact that you can actually see how a finished certificate will look like for each of your recipients. Here is the certificate for Nate Orosso, for Gabriella, for Selma Hickman, and here in the email section, you can preview all of the emails. Again, just feel free to select different recipients and to see how their email template will look like. As you can see, there is also some information about the sender email and the sender name, so this is also fully customizable. So if you want, you can send all of your certificates using your custom sender name and custom sender email. So once you are satisfied with how everything looks like, there is this last step to hit this button, save and preview. So right now, Certifier is generating 10 certificates based on our Google Forms responses and delivers them straight to our recipients. So let me now show you how this whole experience looks like from the point of recipient. So this is basically how this email looks like. As you can see, it has my name in the subject line. It's all branded to the Scully Academy, a school that conducted this quiz on planets and the solar system basics. Now I can simply click on this button and get redirected to my certificate. We can see my certificate on the right. We can see all of the information about our issuer on the left. We can see our issuer's name, Kelly Academy, the links to their social media, the links to their website. You can get acquainted with all of that. And as a recipient, I can also download the certificate straight to my laptop in the form of PDF or simply share it on one of the social media that's available here or by clicking on this copy link button. And a third-party viewer can also verify the validity of the certificate by simply clicking on this verification button placed in the top right-hand corner. And there you go! You just learned how to make your students happy by giving them a stunning certificate generated straight from your Google Forms. By the way, if you are looking for a way to further automate this entire process, a Zapier integration might be something that you should check out. We have a separate tutorial devoted to this topic and I will leave the link to this tutorial in the description box. And remember, if you are looking for an application that will allow you to create, send and manage all of your digital certificates, then you might want to check certifier.io or simply sign up for free by clicking on the first link in the description box. If you found this video helpful, put it a thumbs up. Thank you very much for watching and see you in our next video. Bye!